Welcome to our missionary stories. We're so thankful that you tuned in. We're still teaching about Samuelito from Mexico. And we're so thankful that we also don't not only have New Testaments for English, but we also have New Testaments for Spanish. So if you have any Spanish friends, you write to our post office box number and we will send you New Testaments in Spanish. It will not have the beautiful cover that mine has, the New Testament, but it still has the same message. And we will be glad to send those to you. We want every person in this city to be saved. And this is what is needed today. And as I teach you these lessons, I want to ask you a question. One of the things I want to start with today is, what about when you go to the mailbox and you get a letter? Do you take it home and throw it down on the table and never pick it up and open it? What do you do when you receive a letter that's written to you? The first thing you do is to open it even sometimes before you get in the house. Well, this book is God's love letter to every person in the world. Do you know the love of Christ? If you do, you will tell others about Him. And I know I have so many people that have given these New Testaments out. I don't want to leave anyone out. Dolores Vanderveer has been a great blessing in giving out these New Testaments. I have so many missionaries that are doing this. And Linda Day. These are two of the women. And I could mention more and more, and maybe I will, but I just want you to know they're putting them in prisons. They are giving these out every place in this city. I want every person that's listening today that is a true child of God to pray for everyone that goes out that souls will be saved. You see, we pray for 100-fold. We pray for 100-fold. Every person that listens on cable, every person that receives a New Testament. And as we taught you the little colors of the wordless book and have shown you the wordless book, that we also give these out. And we have more people helping us and praying for us in this city. It is absolutely amazing what God does. So we still give these out free also. You see, since I don't do this for money, this is the greatest blessing, that we can do more for the Lord than anyone because we are able to use all the money that comes in for the glory of God. That's what I serve Him for His glory. Let us love one another in this city and let us reach this city for Christ. So we have seen the little boy and how much this lady had taught him about the Word of God. He didn't even have a Bible. And we have Bibles and don't even open them. You see, that's what this is about. If we get this book and don't read it, then it doesn't help us any. So we must read the book and obey it. So God's Word says in His Word, and I want you to listen to John 15, "The Father hath loved me, so have I loved you. Continue in my love. If you keep my commandments, ye shall abide in my love, even as I have kept my Father's commandment and abide in his love. These things have I spoken unto you, that my joy might remain in you, and that your joy might be full." You see, I live the abundant life. I know what the abundant life is. And this is being obedient to God and being in His will and in everything giving thanks. For this is the will of God in Christ Jesus concerning you. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. Greater love hath no man than this, that a man lay down his life for his friends. This is Christ's love for you. He laid down his life for you. Do you know what he did when he hung on that cross? Every sin that you have committed was on him. All we like sheep have gone astray. We've turned everyone to his own way, and the Lord hath laid on him the iniquity of us all. Isaiah 53:6. All of our sins were laid on him. Ye are my friends if you do whatsoever I command you. Henceforth I call you not servants, for this servant knoweth not what his Lord doeth, but I have called you friends, for all things that I have heard of my Father, I have made known unto you. Jesus Christ came to make known and magnify the Father. The Holy Spirit came to make known and magnify the Son. Ye have not chosen me, but I have chosen you and ordained you that you should go and bring forth much fruit. If you're not bringing forth fruit, I asked you three questions today. Am I glorifying the Lord? Am I bearing fruit? Is my ministry a joy? All of these must be in every believer's life. Let's pray. Our gracious and dear Heavenly Father, we truly praise Thee for Thy word. We thank Thee for the promises that are exceeding great and precious. Every promise is sealed by the precious blood. We thank Thee and praise Thee for every person that is listening, every person that prays, every person that gives. We rejoice today in all of the blessings of knowing Thee as personal Savior. Help people to get in this book and receive the great blessings, more precious than gold that perishes, sweeter than honey to our taste. Help everybody to see that the overflow of our Bible, of our love for those, is when we have the overflow of God's Word blessing those around us. Thank Thee for hearing and answering our prayers today. In Christ's name I pray. Amen. So as we get back to Samuelito, we see how he was faithful to pray. Now let me ask you, when you pray, do you believe that you're going to receive these promises that God has given to us? If you doubt, you shall not receive any good thing. So you must believe. And this little boy has faith greater than any of ours. Every time they would pray, his mother would say, he is just going to be disappointed again. And they prayed every day for him to be able to go to school, every day for his father to be well. After a few months, his father became stronger and stronger. His father was able to go back to work. And when his mother would say, you'll be disappointed, he said, the missionary said that when she prayed for my father, and he is well and working again. She prayed for me to go to school, and I am going to be able to go to school. And I am praying. They prayed every day for his father to be saved. They tried to talk to his father and teach him the colors of the wordless book, that all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. He wouldn't listen. He said, this is why we have had so much trouble, because you have done this wickedness and listened to this missionary. This is why we have so much trouble. We don't need any more trouble. But they still continued to pray. All the time, every time they would pray, he would believe that God was going to answer. So he did the best he could. He told others about the Lord Jesus Christ. When he would tell the blind man, he would say, "All have sinned and come short of the glory of God." The blind man pretended like he didn't listen at first. And then he would give him, he was so kind, Samuelito was, he would even give him some of his money for his box because he was blind. And because this boy was so kind, he began to listen. When he taught him the word of God, it was amazing what he told him, Romans 3:23. All have sinned and come short of the glory of God. But he said, "My sin is so bad, God can never forgive me. That's why I am blind." You see, that's why we had to know this story from God's Word in chapter 9 of the book of John. We had to know that it's not because of your sin, but it's for the glory of God that you are suffering, whatever it is. It is for the glory of God. And he didn't know how to tell this man that it wasn't because of his sin that he was blind. He did not know this, but you can know it so you can tell others. You can know this today. And then he kept talking to him every day, and he would tell him every day over and over, and he prayed for him. And one day, as he was telling him about heaven, what heaven is like, Samuelito said, "You will be able to see all of these things. You will be able to see all of these things." He had tears in his eyes, and he said, "I believe. I truly believe." He had told him, just like the blind man in the Bible, that not to listen to this wickedness of this lady. And he came to know Christ because this little boy continued to tell him the truth. He kept saying, "This woman is good. I know this woman is good. I know she tells the truth." And now, this blind man is going to be there because of this little boy's faithfulness. What about those of you that are listening? Do you do this for those around you? You must. That's the only way they're going to know. And if you know Christ, you will love those around you. You will love. Because if you don't love, here's what God's Word says. Listen what God's Word says. These are strong words, and they are for every person that is listening. He says in 1 John, we love him because he first loved us. If a man say, "I love God," and hateth his brother, he is a liar. And he that loveth not his brother, whom he hath seen, how can he love God whom he hath not seen? 1 John 3, verse 15. Whosoever hateth his brother is a murderer. And we know that no murderer hath eternal life abiding in him. We see this is God's Word. He loved this man, and he came to Christ. Who do you love today that even hates you that you could tell about Christ? This little boy had faith greater than anything we have. One day he saw these strange men get off of a bus, and he wanted to shine their shoes, and they pushed him away. They talked to the men that were at the lunchroom where the bus comes. That's where everyone was in the village. And he said, "We need volunteers." These men did. "How many of you will volunteer?" "Oh, see, they all were going to volunteer." He ran home as fast as his legs could carry him, with his shoeshine box in his hand. He walked in the house and he said, A miracle has happened. "Papa, a miracle has happened. God has answered our prayers. God has answered our prayers. There is going to be a school higher up in the mountains than where we live." Papa said, "Don't be disappointed, boy. It can never happen." "Papa, it is going to happen. The men in the village said they would help. They asked for help." My son, please listen to me. They could never get the steel up this mountain. They could never get the wood up this mountain. The ambulance couldn't even get up this mountain. But Papa, these men said they were going to build. Papa, I know that God has answered my prayers. I know this is a miracle." Just like the missionary said. He said, "Son, it will never happen." The people in Mexico City had decided that all the little villages needed a school. They brought truckloads in. The steel and the wood already prepared. All they had to do was put it together, the schools. When his father saw this, he had tears. He said, "Papa, will you help him? Will you help him?" "See, son, we will help." The school went up faster than anybody ever believed. This little boy never doubted that God would answer every prayer that he prayed. You see, the problem is we don't pray. We have not because we ask not. The problem is we don't have faith in God's word. The problem is we don't worship Him in spirit and in truth. Because when we worship Him, we believe. When we worship Him, we praise Him for the answers. This is real worship. This is what this little boy did. The day came when he was able to go to school and carry his books. He couldn't even read. Within a year, he was beginning to read. Every day he would take his lunch. Every day he was amazed at the bathroom and the showers. He was amazed that this school was just up the mountain. God had done exceeding abundantly above all they would ever ask. He was going to have to leave and go to the city to school. Now he can stay at home. You see, God loves those children in Mexico and India and China, all over the world. He loves every person around you. But you see, we as believers have failed to love them and give out the word to them. What are you doing to reach these children for Christ? After this, he said, "Now, Father, you will believe. Father, you will believe." He said, "No, I can't believe." He said, "But Papa, you have seen what the missionary said. It all came true. Mama's believed, and I have believed, and little sister has believed, and we want you to be in the family of God. Oh, Papa, please." One night, in their little room, one-room house, he heard him talking to his mother. If I believe, all of my friends will think I'm a baby. That is, believing is for women and children, not for men. She said, they will laugh at you and call you a baby, but you will be a child of God, and you will go to heaven someday. He heard him. He got up so he could help his father. He wanted to show him that it was the blood that cleanses him, and it was the blood that would cleanse him from all sin. Not just one, but from all sin. The blood of Jesus Christ, his Son, cleanses us from all sin. You see, in Christ, we have redemption through his blood, even the forgiveness of sin. He didn't know this Bible verse, but he saw the faith in his own Son. He saw such faith in him. For by grace are you saved through faith, and that not of yourselves. It is a gift of God, not of works, lest any man should boast. What do people see in you? He saw something in his Son, and he knew that he must accept this gift. This little boy that couldn't even read led his mother to Christ, his sister to Christ, and the blind man. And now his father. One day they got something in the mail. He was so excited. He opened it, and it was a Bible. You see, his teacher had written to the missionary. Samuelito would tell her what to write. When he received this Bible, he knew that somebody had to read it for him because he couldn't read. His teacher would read the letters that he would get, and she would write his letters to the missionary. When he showed her this Bible, she said, "We cannot show it to the other children or we will be in trouble." He said, "I want you to write and tell the missionary all the answers to prayer that she prayed for me. That Papa is saved, Mama is saved, little sister is saved, and the blind man. And I'm going to school and learning to read. And I have received the Bible." His father became angry because the boys wouldn't play with his son. Because, see, now he would not do those evil things that he did before and do the things that they were doing that he knew was sin. His father became angry because the men laughed at him. He wanted to fight back, but he knew he couldn't because this wasn't God's way. He had to be kind and good to those. You see, he had to do like God's word says, to love your enemy. When the teacher would come, she would read and teach them the truth. She was also learning God's word. She taught them to love their enemies and to pray for them. She taught them the word of God. This little boy, a miracle, not only one miracle, but a miracle for every person that is saved. What about you? Do you know the Lord Jesus Christ as Savior? Have you accepted him? You see, he's a gift, and he must be accepted by faith. Without faith, it's impossible to please God. Whatsoever is not of faith is sin. Faith is just believing what God says he will do. That's why we need to pray. Why aren't your prayers being answered? You could ask. Maybe it's because God's word says, if I regard iniquity in my heart, the Lord will not hear me. You must come before God as a clean vessel. Now, are you going to heaven, to this beautiful place that God has prepared? We saw last week, it's a place of wonderful description, absolute perfection. You see, this is amazing, isn't it? Revelation 21, 27, perfect purity, no sin can enter heaven. Perfect provision, Revelation 7, 16, perfect protection. You see, today we have divine protection. Then we're not going to even need any gates. You see, in heaven, we have the gates, a solid pearl, and they're going to be open day and night. Gates are for protection. You see, this is what we need to know Christ. And we're not thinking about seeing Him in heaven. We're thinking about seeing the street of pure gold and the street is pure gold. We're thinking about seeing Him because He's the light of heaven. And then happy associations, the redeemed of all ages. We're going to see Moses and we're going to see Elijah and Paul and John, all of the men of the Bible that wrote the book. Revelation 21, 24, 1 Thessalonians 4, 17, the loved ones that have gone before. And then with blessed emancipation, Revelation 21, 4, no more pain, no more sorrow, and Revelation 7, 17, no more tears. Now we know these are earthly things, and they're going to be taken away. We know what they're like, but we do not know the glories of heaven because God is the light. This is going to be perfect light. And you know, as we get to hell, we'll have to describe that another time. You see, hell is a place for those that reject Christ. You see, a place of fire and brimstone. This is where Satan's kingdom is. And this is abominable corruption. Everything that defiles, Revelation 21, 27. Wicked associations. You don't like wicked people today? You don't want to be around them? You're going to be with them forever and ever. Conscious condemnation. You're going to know the pain of being in a place where it's the blackness of darkness forever and fire and brimstone. The worms crawling on your body. Endless desperation. Gnashing and yelling of teeth. Endless adoration. Why don't we begin to serve the Lord today and worship Him? Everlasting worship. Revelation 5:12 and 5:13. Is your name written in the Lamb's Book of Life? Do you want to go to a place where there's no love, no joy, no peace, suffering forever and ever and ever? I plead with you and beg you today to just simply do like this little boy did. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ and thou shalt be saved. Don't wait. Tomorrow may be too late. I pray that we have learned today how we are to be obedient to God.
Be it in the town or country or the busy avenue, Africa or Asia, the task is up to you. Be a missionary every day. Tell the world that Jesus is the way. The Lord is soon returning. There is no time for losing. So be a missionary. God's own emissary, be a missionary too.